Okay, here at Purgatory, one of my favorite things to run as a special during the summer months or even on a cool day like today is a blackened grouper sandwich. There's nothing that I find just more pleasuring than the crispy outside, creamy inside of a steaky piece of grouper. Again, it's nice and refreshing, but yet it'll warm you up as well. So we're going to start off with our piece of grouper here. We've got about a 5 to 6 ounce piece of grouper. And we're going to place it here in our blackening seasoning. We want to get a good coating on there because, again, we want that nice crust. So we've got that crispy outside and nice smooth inside. We've got a hot pan here. We're adding just a little bit of olive oil. We like to use a bit of pomace oil here. And that much smoke is okay. That's what we're looking for. Really toasting those peppers in there. It's gonna a lot of nice flavor come through. So, and again, it lends itself really well to this type of fish. So it is flaky, but it's a little bit steaky as well.
And John, what's in the seasoning?
The seasoning is a traditional Cajun seasoning blend. It's a lot of cayenne pepper, paprika, thyme, black pepper, a nice amount of salt as well. The oil that we're using is what we call it's called a pomace oil, and so it's olive oil actually, but it doesn't have the heavy olive flavor. So we get a lot of the benefits of olive oil without the heavy olive flavor. So. And it's got a nice high smoke point, as you can see. We did get a lot of smoke in there. A lot of that's just due to the pepper, the hot pan. But it does allow us to heat the pan to a higher point without the oil combusting or igniting, if you will. So.
And does the smoke add to the flavor?
The smoke does not really add to the flavor. No, it's the smoke is basically just the seasonings and the oil burning off of the pan. So what we're looking for here is once we get this going here, the fish has almost an automatic release on it. So you shouldn't really have to push too much on here to get the fish off of the pan. The fish will release when it's got a nice good blackened crust on here. And as you can see, we're here now. When you flip these, you always want to flip them away from you so that you don't get the oil on you. Now you can see this nice blackened crust on the outside. Again, it looks black, it looks dark, but it's actually not burnt. These peppers all lend themselves to the flavor that we're looking for. Again, this is a nice crispy outside. If you could hear this, you can almost tap on it. And again, that's what we're looking for. Now what I did when I flipped it is I'm actually gonna turn the heat down to about medium or so here. We're just gonna let the fish finish up so we don't get it too overly cooked here. And it's gonna take about a total of a minute and a half to 2 minutes on each side. And again, this is about a 5 to 6 ounce piece of red grouper here that we're using. It's a good 3/4 of an inch thick, about an inch thick in some spots here. So.
And people always want to know, does it taste fishy?
Grouper is not quite as fishy as one would think. If you're familiar with a halibut or even a walleye or something like that, it has about that fishiness, if you will. It does have some oil in it. The oils tend to be what lend to the fishy flavor. So that's why a salmon or something like that is has a much stronger flavor. This does not have as much oil in it. A little bit flakier, but again, it is still has a somewhat of a steak-like texture to it. It's kind of a middle of the road fish, if you will. But again, not too fishy at all by any standards. So again, really refreshing. Goes really well with these seasonings, and we're almost done here. So this has got a nice crisp bottom on it now. So we're gonna take this off here. We're gonna put it on. What we have here is just a toasted sourdough bun, and I'm gonna put it right here. And I like to serve this with something just as simple as you could do a tartar sauce. We kind of make our own mayonnaise-based sauces or aiolis, if you will. This is mayonnaise with some lemon zest, lemon juice, some good black pepper, a little bit of salt, and some fresh chives. And we're just gonna put this right here on the top of the bun here. Serve it up with a little bit of lettuce, tomato, onion, chives, whatever your choice of accoutrement or topping is to your sandwich. And here's what we have is a piece of blackened grouper here at a Purgatory Golf Club.
Looks beautiful. And what beverage would go best with that?
If it were me, I would prefer to have a, I would have a beer with this, and I would actually go with maybe a light IPA. A couple that we've had in-house recently would be a Brooklyn IPA. It's a very drinkable, and that's an India Pale Ale. And the reason I say that is because the hoppiness, or the bitterness in the beer is going to help balance out the blackening and the oiliness from the mayonnaise. And again, it's a very strong flavored sandwich as far as seasonings. So you want a beer or a beverage that's really going to kind of cut through everything. So I would definitely recommend an IPA or a full-bodied lager of some sort. So
sounds wonderful. Let's have lunch.
Will do.
So tell us about the beer, John.
Yeah, after completing the blackened grouper here, again with the lemon chive mayonnaise, again, I had mentioned serving this with an IPA or a mild IPA or something that has a little bit of bitterness or hoppiness to it. We've actually elected to use Three Floyds Pride and Joy, which is an American pale ale, which is a little bit milder than a typical IPA, but again, it's brewed right here in Indiana. So this is what I would serve with this. This is going to be a great combination if you were to indulge in this here at Purgatory.
That's great. Thank you, John.
Thank you.